Good morning, Munir Ajam, with another video on the project management educational series. I'm recording this video on the 16th of January, 2017, but it might not be posted until a few days later because I'm in a remote area where there is a little bit of restriction on social media sites. I'm delivering a workshop in on the Caspian Sea for an oil and gas company. and during our discussion yesterday, I will probably be recording a few videos from here as it relates to the courses, to some of the topics we cover in these workshops. Of course, I'm not going to present all the workshops, 5 days of training, but I will pick up on some items here and there. Today, I'm going to talk about professional association of project management because this was one of the topics we mentioned yesterday. Typically, you know, wherever we go, many organizations over depend on PMI. They basically think PMI and PMP certification and the PMBOK is the only standard, the only books. And we've covered these topics many times before. And unfortunately, or fortunately, whatever the case might be, depend from which perspective you look at this, yesterday's group was the same. So we talked about, okay, and the question is, okay, if PMI and PMP are not the only one out there, what else is there? Well, in PMI, by itself, there are 8 certifications, if I'm not mistaken, 8 or 9, on project management. But I think we've talked about PMI in the past quite enough. The only thing I want to say right now is the PMI, when it comes to managing a project, the PMI main standard is the PMBOK, or guide, is the PMBOK guide. And the PMBOK guide focuses on project management processes and knowledge areas. And ISO, in 2012, standard association or standard organization from around the world, maybe, 16, 17, 20 organizations from different countries around the world, they had published, working with ISO, in 2012, ISO 21500, which is a guidance on project management. Now, that guide, it's about 40 pages or so, that which would be considered equivalent to the PMI ANSI approved PMI standard, which include focus on process groups, but and knowledge areas, but ISO call them subjects, and also ISO uses some information from other resources, so it's not just PMI in the process group. They touch on things from IPMA and others. So who's out there? Well, PMI we know. ISO 21500 is a guidance on project management published by ISO in 2012 and focuses on, as I just mentioned, on subject areas, which are 10, and process groups, which are 5, and processes, and if I'm not mistaken, there are 39 processes. So this is ISO. Okay, beside ISO, what do we have out there? We have the International Project Management Association, IPMA. Now, IPMA is quite different than PMI because IPMA is more like an umbrella organization, which is membership is association from different countries around the world. So basically, as individual, it would be quite challenging to get a membership in IPMA. Usually, in your country, if there is an association for project management for the whole country, usually, that association might belong to IPMA. So you become a member in your national association, in your country association, and that association is typically a member in IPMA, of course, if they choose to. Like, for example, there is an IPMA USA, so one organization for the whole USA, IPMA in Canada, IPMA in many European countries and around the world. IPMA focus, if we think about their standard initially, it used to be focus, and still to a degree, of course, is on competence. So PMI focus and ISO focus on processes, IPMA focus on competence. And the most recent IPMA competence baseline, or actually it used to be called IPMA competence baseline, ICB, they changed it to more than one guide now. So they have now in 2015, I believe, IPMA published individual competence baseline, and they publish organizational competence baseline, and they publish also things for project and project excellence model and other things, but less they focus, you know, on closer to project management right now before expanding the definition. So IPMA competence baseline, if I'm not mistaken, again, that have 29 competence elements in three groups. Again, maybe one day in the future we can focus on explaining these things, but for today we just want to focus on just that. So IPMA is another organization. They do have certification. They have four certification. They're more level. They call them level. So basically the idea is that they are, and you don't have to get one to get the other, but in a way they are interlinked. So basically you have level D is the lowest level, which is a knowledge-based foundation. And then you have foundation certification, and then you have IPMA level C, which would be considered a project manager for simple project. Maybe that's a better way to define this. And then IPMA level B, which is like a senior project manager or someone who can manage complex project. And then IPMA level A, which is more like a project director, which is the highest level certification. So in a way, IPMA certification is linked to a position, which is different than PMI, because PMI, for example, the PMP, some people think is a project manager professional. It's not. It's project management professional. That means someone who is working in project management, basically. Where IPMA, from level C upward, they actually certify you as a project manager. But they say if you have C, which is slightly higher than the PMP, or maybe a lot higher than the PMP, okay, but most people do not know that, is IPMA level C is you are technically certified as a project manager that can manage simple or small project or work as a deputy to on a large and complex project. Yeah, so you can see the difference in marketing and terminology that is used by organization. You know, many people who become PMPs, they think, wow, these guys now, they can manage a mega project. Unfortunately, that belief is there, and that's the power of marketing. Yeah. You know, the power of marketing, sometimes we say, you know, a good marketer can sell you fish at sea. You know, before they even fish it, they can sell it to you. Unfortunately, that's the reality sometimes with PMI. We are sold the big things, but in reality, what we're getting is something less. So IPMA focus on the individual positions, technically, and focus on competence. So basically, the difference here, maybe I should have another video, and there is an interesting video published by a friend as well on the difference between knowledge and competence. quickly, we can say knowledge, usually you can test it in an exam, like what PMP does, and you can basically prove that you have the knowledge. Yeah, and you have a general idea about the field. Whereas competence is you have to prove you are competent. Yeah, so basically to get IPMA certification, for the lower one, for D, there is a certificate, exam based, but for C and above, there are C, there is exam plus interviews, and I think D, B and A are only interviews. So basically you have to be assessed by a professional assessor who holds the certification or higher. And basically, it's not like, yeah, I know how the definition of what a free float is, or I know how in theory what the critical pass. The key here is, can you demonstrate that you're able to do it? So these are the two leading organizations in the world, if we wish to say, and they both started in the 1960s. I think IPMA in the 1964 and PMI in 1969. Outside of these organizations, there are other organizations. There is an organization called GAPS, which is the Global Alliance for Project Performance Standard. And these guys are also, they try to link with all these different organizations, and they publish on competence as well. And they have standard. So far, I believe they have published three standards, one for project manager standard, one program manager standard, and one that is project sponsor standard. One thing I did not say about IPMA, which is true also for GAPS, these guys are quite generous with knowledge. So any information that's published, anyone can download it free from the internet, from their website. And GAPS, I think, even allow you to share freely as long as you credit the source and you don't remove the copyright or the Creative Commons guideline from their materials. Whereas PMI, unless you are a member, you cannot get anything. Beside GAPS, there are other organizations. One was established less than 10 years ago. It's called GPM Global, which is SUCAD. We have partnered with them. And these guys focus on sustainability in project management. So basically, their focus is project management and sustainable, using sustainable method, and they have a methodology called PRISM, which is project integrating sustainability methods, and they have what we call the P5 standard, which stands for basically people, planet, profit or prosperity, plus project and process. So basically, this is the main guide or the standard that they publish. Outside these organizations that are more interested in general project management, I think GAPS here among these four is unique, where it does not offer certification and does not offer membership. So it's quite a unique organization. Again, you know, this might be a separate topic in the future. Other than that, there are a lot of organizations that are specialized, such as AACE, which is focusing on cost and schedule engineering, and they have probably about 10 certifications. You have SAVE International, which is focused on value management and value engineering. You have the ASQ, which is American Society of Quality. And of course, unfortunately, I'm more maybe biased, not biased, but because my education and most of my experience has been US related, so I know many of the US-based organizations. Now, outside the international arena, general arena in US, there are many organizations that are country, you know, specific, like Project Management South Africa or Australia or Japan or in Singapore or Kazakhstan or Russia. Some of these associations are probably totally independent, and some of them probably member in IPMA. I stop here. This is basically give just general introduction that's what exists in the world of project management beyond PMI and the PMP certification. Hopefully this has been helpful, and thank you. We'll talk again.